said that this is a tipping point, and I really do agree with her that this is. She has opened this really extraordinarily energetic and moving celebration of classics at Royal Holloway in Bedford, and I think in this sense of saying that what matters here is that this is the start of a national issue about classics. And I felt that it would be appropriate for me to add how it is also very much a London issue, especially for Royal Holloway's sister colleges, including my own University College London. Changes to the organisation of higher education in the UK has made university departments work often in intense competition with each other, endlessly vying for the most and the best staff and students. But in London, there are so many respects in which the study of the ancient world is a collaboration, intellectual and social, between the staff and the students of colleges like Royal Holloway, UCL, and King's, the places where classics matters in all its many integrated manifestations as language, literature, history, philosophy, art, material culture, and reception. Now, colleagues from different London colleges regularly undertake research with each other on projects or debate with each other about classical matters in seminars that we run between us all in our own institutions and in the Institute of Classical Studies. But we also teach together. UCL, for example, has enjoyed a long partnership with Royal Holloway in the teaching of ancient philosophy. At both undergraduate and postgraduate levels, even though that happy partnership has been beset by the many technical challenges of video conferencing. But perhaps one of the most fundamental, influential, large-scale and enjoyable collaborations between us all arises from the intercollegiate master's programmes in classics, ancient history, classical art and archaeology, and late antique and Byzantine studies.